Welcome to this demonstration of the Cisco Trusted Path Routing solution. Routing is one of the most important parts of the infrastructure that keeps a network running, and it is absolutely critical that devices have maintained their hardware and software integrity. Customers who depend on critical infrastructure require that their sensitive data flows transport across only trustworthy network devices. A few questions to ask yourself include: if hardware or software running my critical systems was modified, how would I know? In an audit, how can I prove my systems are running compliant hardware and software? How would I prove where and when critical security updates are applied and are active? How do I ensure that traffic is routed only across trustworthy devices? System integrity is the foundation of trust, and trust is built and maintained as a result of reliable and continuous verification of evidences. It begins in the hardware, as the trust needs to be anchored to hardware-level root of trust and also be verifiable cryptographically. It is based on a broad set of measurements related to hardware, boot, and software. And such measurements need to not just be collected and validated at the boot time, but also in the runtime for ongoing maintenance of trust. The last component is the visualization and reporting of variable evidences to maintain the trust posture status. With the help of Trusted Path Routing, we show having continuous evaluation on the integrity of routers in the traffic path. We can dynamically steer the sensitive flows to only take the path with verified devices. Let's look at the major components of Cisco Trusted Path Routing. The core components of the solution are: network devices running secure iOS XR operating system, a programmable segment routing network, a trust verification service using Cisco Crosswork Trust Insights. In the background, a trust verification service does a periodic evaluation of trust across all the network devices. If the verification service cannot establish the trusted state of a device, the device is taken out of the network path for sensitive flows. Cisco Network Services Orchestrator deploys services with a trusted transport intent that guarantees sensitive traffic transits only through trustworthy devices. Let's dig deeper on how trust is established. Trust is focused on measuring and validating the integrity of the device. Once boot integrity is established during runtime, whenever a binary is to be loaded, a measurement happens in the kernel and is verified against Cisco published known good values. When a mismatch is found, it indicates that the trust verification service cannot establish the trustworthiness of the device. Here's an example of how the runtime measurement looks. The iOS XR trust dossier provided by the device contains details of hardware inventory, installed software packages, runtime measurements, and a human-readable JSON format. The integrity of this dossier is ensured by signing the entire response using a key that is stored in a secure storage location, protected by the Trust Anchor module in the hardware. Let's look at what the trust evaluation process looks like with Cisco Crosswork Trust Insights. The Trust Verification Service requests for dossier along with a nonce value. The device then gathers the measurements along with the nonce value and creates the attestation dossier. This is then signed and returned to the verification service. Cisco Crosswork Trust Insights validates the signature, verifies the nonce value, and then uses the measurements to compare against Cisco published known good values. Let's take a closer look at Crosswork Trust Insights, which is included with Cisco iOS XR7 software system. Two capabilities that we'll see in the upcoming demonstration include visualizing and reporting on the trustworthiness of the network and trust infrastructure, simplifying operations as the single place to audit hardware, software, and runtime evidence. We can also track the changes in the network devices over time. And at the same time, it provides cryptographic, verifiable proof of what happened in the network in the past. Now that we understand how trust evaluation happens and how it can be used for trusted path routing, let's look at a demonstration of the solution in action. The user interface in this demo displays a topology of routers that are part of a segment routing network. The topology rendered by the application is collected from a segment routing path computation element. The PCE's database includes the node and link information of the network. For example, one could visualize the different metrics associated with the links in the topology, such as IGP metric and the delay metric, which in this case is the actual measured delay in microseconds between the routers. Lastly, the network provides several transport slices implemented by segment routing flexible algorithm instances. For example, FlexAlgo 128 provides a transport slice that minimizes the delay between routers. We call it the low latency slice. And FlexAlgo 140 provides a slice that also minimizes delay, but in addition, it considers the trust state of a node. We call it the trusted low latency slice. If we drill into a node, like Budapest, one can see the different prefix segment identifiers associated with this node. Basically, we have a single prefix, 25, 25, 25, 25, assigned to its loopback interface, and different MPLS labels, one for each of the FlexAlgo instances. In the topology, we've set up two VPNs between Dublin and Budapest. One VPN is steered over the low latency slice, while the other VPN, with privacy-sensitive traffic, is steered over the trusted low-latency slice. From the moment a node is brought up online, the trust verification service regularly evaluates the trust state of each device in the network. Initially, when devices are not compromised, and as seen by the paths to Budapest over the transport slices mentioned earlier, the traffic would take the path through the router Milano. In this case, the end-to-end delay is dominated by the delay of the link between Barcelona and Milano, which is 2 milliseconds. Switching to a live graph, which plots the delay of the traffic over the network, we can see that the traffic for both VPNs experiences a delay of around 2 milliseconds, as expected. Going back to the main topology view and drilling into router Milano, we can see on the right-hand side that this device is currently in the trusted state. At this point, we proceed to compromise the router by corrupting one of the iOS XR binaries. In this demonstration, we do this by appending a random string to the target binary. In the background, the verification service re-evaluates the trust status of the device. This is done by initiating an SSH connection to the router to fetch the platform's trust dossier. The signed trust dossier package is then sent back to the verification service by the router. Once the dossier is received, the verification service compares the received measurements with the published known good values. We can now see that the router Milano is treated as an untrusted device. As a result, the router is removed from the trusted low latency slice. From this point onwards, regular traffic continues to flow through router Milano, while sensitive traffic traverses the network over a new minimum delay path that excludes the compromised device Milano. To verify, we switch again to the live graphs. We can observe that the sensitive traffic has moved to a new path where the latency is now 4 milliseconds. While on the other hand, the regular traffic continues to use the original path through the compromised device with a latency of 2 milliseconds. This demonstration showed how trusted path routing can help secure your customers' traffic. You must start with hardware and software that is built with trust. Next, software helps measure and audit to maintain device integrity. Then your customers benefit by routing their traffic only through trustworthy devices. This solution secures the critical data flows across the service provider infrastructure. Thank you for joining us for this demonstration of Cisco's trusted routing solution. For more information, please visit cisco.com/go/trustyournetwork.